Okay guys, so now I'm going to... Hi guys, and welcome to a live demonstration, a live video from chesslessons.blog. What I'm going to do is to play a live game and try to analyze the way I think during a game. I usually post analysis games after I played and I have seen them in order to be more specific in my analysis, but I thought it would be fun to see a live game and see how it's going to happen. So I usually play classical games about 20 minutes at least, but okay, now we should play what game do I have in pro? Okay, so here we go. Okay, so e4 e6, we're going to have some kind of French defense exchange variation, I think, setup. Sorry for the trash language before. And okay, so my opponent plays d3. This is closing this bishop over here as I have closed mine. And I'm wondering what happens if I respond d4 and then e4 and fix my pawns. Yes, and it's going to be actually a French defense reversed. That's interesting. Okay, I have some other plans. I will play here. So now the knight is pinned, of course. There is a threat of d4. Bishop there. Now I don't want to exchange that bishop. My bishop is great there, and I seek to create some problems in a white structure. But I don't see the way. He's very solid right now. So okay, let's go for our first plan. I play here because after I fix his pawn, he's light square bishop would be his bad bishop, and I leave him with the bad bishop, and I have exchanged his good bishop. So, what I have told right now is that his dark square bishop had the most squares, and his light square bishop has very few squares. So, I exchanged his bishop with many squares, which is the good bishop of his, and I left him with the bad bishop. Now, let's see. I suspect that there might be a possibility here to go for castle on the queen side, so I will take my chance. I will first play here, even if now I don't have the c5. Okay. Yes. Knight there, and I will play here. Now, c3 is a move my opponent has to consider at some point, because it's a very good move. And now I play here, and I keep both my chances open for castling in either side. Now, what I'm doing is to develop all of my pieces. I make sure that my rooks are going to connect each other, and the right moment, I'm going to decide about where to attack and how. Right now, my opponent played the break c3, and now he has 1-2 forces. I have 1-2, and if I castle, I will have 3 forces. But if I castle and he exchanges, he's opening a file, and he's probably going to have a kind of attack. But I can break with f5. Okay, I'm going to try it. I'm going to try castle on the queen side, which is kind of more aggressive. More aggressive because my opponent has the majority of his pieces gathered on the king side, which means he cannot attack quickly on my queen side, while my pieces are aiming towards his king side, especially after knight here. And of course, if we exchange many pieces, I think this is for my good, because I'm going to break, make a pawn break somehow like this. And now, okay, my opponent has a trap here to play the rook here, and after that I cannot take with the knight. Actually, I can, because c7 is guarded by the queen, so no problem. No problem at all. And now I have to watch what happens with my e5 pawn. A very important rule, reason why we should not move pawns too recklessly is because they cannot go back, and that means they leave weak squares behind them. And now this pawn is weak because there is no pawn to protect them. Okay, I speak a lot and think a little. Is this? No, it's not dropping a pawn yet, but of course. Okay, let's see. Yes, I actually said a Greek word. I think it's dropping a pawn, yes. Because after here, you can take now, the queen is falling. Because this pawn is pinned. Oh! Actually, yes, you lose a piece. You don't lose the queen, but your piece down. Now, I have a winning position. And it is very important to bring your rooks on the 7th or 2nd rank. Very, very, very important in order to dominate in the game. And now I will pin that knight and probably exchange it. What? Let me see. I take your knight, you take my rook, I take your rook, you take my bishop, and we have exchanged all, but I'm left with... No, I don't. I will play here in order to keep the domination over the 7th rank, the 2nd rank, because your knight is pinned. There is no need yet to take you. Okay, a check is a check. Nothing more. And... I think it's right to let my opponent know that I'm making a video with commentary. And is it with double M? Okay, I'm not. Okay, I have only 4 minutes. I will explain my friend with message later. Okay. So he played here, and actually I have to play fast. Ah, okay, here is another blunder, possibly. Yes, yes. Yes, I have a huge problem with when my comes under a second, under a minute, and now actually I am cautious in order not to lose a winning position because of time pressure. Because okay, everyone has his weaknesses. Time pressure is mine. It doesn't let me think right. Now. The plan is very, very easy. I'm going to take that pawn, or even if there was no pawn there, I was going to play there. And now this is tricky. This is very tricky because the rook can come here, but look what. I'm placing all of my pieces in dark squares. Okay, so that bishop cannot threat them. And after that, I'm going to make a window on my king and not in the color of the bishop, so I'm going to make a window in the dark squares. And after, okay, I blunder the rook, but I'm still a pawn, a rook up. That happens when you speak a lot and think a little. So let me see now, because I don't want to blunder anything else. Now I'm going for a little bit to stop saying much because I have about 3 minutes and this is kind of crucial point in the game. Oh, my friend! Exchange of the rooks? Can you win that endgame? I'm not sure about that. Because, not of course because you are who you are, because I think no one can win that game, not even Magnus Carlsen can win that endgame. Okay, the bishop was falling there. And there. Okay, I told you that I have tremendous problem with time pressure. And actually I'm kind of, let's play here and he might make the mistake again. Yes, I got a bit anxious, a little anxious about the time, and actually I made a lot of mistakes because there is no additional time in that game, and that means that I have... now, here is a tricky move, because after here, but I will blockade you, and you have to bring your bishop in order. Yes, play fast. Play first, think afterwards. That's probably the worst advice ever. And what do you do after check? Okay, so now my knights are pretty safe. You can take it. I don't care. And I'm going to promote, and probably 1 minute 47 seconds are fine. So I don't believe that I first blundered the rook and then I blundered twice. I left my opponent's blunder twice unpunished, and yes, this is my first time I'm doing a live play and commentary, so I hope in the next games I will be much better. Okay, so that now, okay, this is just winning. Is this mate? I think it is. So, thank you very much, my friend, for the game. Very much for the game. Oh, a rematch. Okay, I think I'm going to give a rematch.